Hi everyone! In this video, I'm going to show you how to use Google Sheets lookup function. The lookup function searches for a key through a row or a column and returns the value of the cell located to the corresponding position of that row or column. Just like VLOOKUP and HLOOKUP, the lookup function allows you to retrieve specific data from your spreadsheet. However, this formula has two distinct differences. The lookup formula only works if the data in your row or column is sorted, and whilst the VLOOKUP only searches vertically and HLOOKUP searches horizontally in a row, lookup can do both. You can use lookup in two different ways. So the first possible syntax is lookup search key, search range, and result range. This option allows you to search for a key in a search range, for example A3 to A12, to return a result from a result range in the same position, for example F3 to F12. Your search key is the value that lookup formula will use to search for the lookup. Your search range is the range of cells in which the function will search for this search key. And then the result range is the range of cells from which the function will pull the result. And the second option is similar, but instead of a result range, we select a result array. And this option allows you to search for a key in the first row or column to return a result from the last row or column in that specific array. So it's the range you want to return a result from, for example, A3 to G15. It will search for the first row or column in the array and pull the result from the last row or column. And if this array contains more or an equal number of columns than rows, then the search will work vertically, searching the first column and pulling a result from the last column. If the array contains more rows and columns, then the lookup will run horizontally within the rows. Now let me show you in practice. Here I've provided different examples on how to use the lookup function. So we have our data range right here, and we want to know what the salary is of Dominic. To do so, we type in lookup, and then our search key is Dominic, so the value to search for in the first row or column. Our search range is A2 to A11. And then of course our result array, because we want to know the salary of Dominic, is D2 to D11. Press enter. There we go. We now know the salary of Dominic, which as we can see is $116,099. Next is the department of Harper, so we're gonna do the same. We look up for Harper in A2 to C11. There we go. And Harper works in marketing. We can do this because the lookup function will search for Harper in the first row or column and then return the result from the last row of our range. Now we want to know the employee that belongs to the employee ID E761. So to do so, we do lookup E761, search in the range B to B, so in the entire column B, and our result range is in column A. There we go. Now we know that the employee ID E761 belongs to Ian, as you can see right here. Next question is who works in the finance department? So let's search for it. We're searching for finance in search range C2 to C11 and result range in A2 to A11. There we go. Christopher works in the finance department. That's correct. It's worth noting that the lookup formula, unlike VLOOKUP and HLOOKUP, can return values before the lookup column. The lookup column here was B and it returned the result from column A. And same for the example in row 5. Our next question is we want to know the salary of the employee from operations. To do so, we're going to look up operations in the range C2 to D11. It's searching for operations in column C and it will return the value from column D, so the salary. There we go. Next, who earns this amount of salary? So we're searching for $82,279. In column D, and of course we want the formula to return the name of this employee. It says Andrew earns this amount of money. Let's see. This is incorrect, as you can tell. The issue that we have right here is that the lookup formula only works with data in ascending order, and our salary is not sorted that way, as you can see. So the formula returns the wrong value, says that Andrew earns this amount of money, which is incorrect. So for this lookup formula to function as expected, you would need to sort this salary in ascending order as well. Now the last example, we're looking for the employee ID of Andrew. So we're going to look up Andrew in the range A2 to B11. There we go. Andrew employee ID indeed is 209. Now let me show you how to apply the lookup formula to a row. We have the same data here, but now horizontally. And we're asking ourselves the same question. So what's the salary of Dominic? To search for it in this range of data, we're of course going to do the lookup, searching for Dominic. In this case, our search range is B1 to K1. And the results come from B4 to K4. There we go. The department of Harper. We're going to look up for Harper in the range B1 to K3. And Harper indeed works in marketing, as you can see. So it works very similarly, but you just, of course, your ranges are now the rows instead of the columns. So it's that easy. Okay, now for my final example, I want to show you how the formula behaves, the lookup formula, when you use different size references. So here I've put the reference size of my formula. In our case, we want to ask, who is the employee that has ID number 589? So in this case, it's supposed to be Finch. What I've used as formula is, I want to, of course, search for this employee ID. And as you can see, my search range was B2 to B5, and my results range is A5 to A11. What you get then, you don't get errors, as you can see, but the results are wrong. So this is not Gary's employee ID, as we can see. It belongs to Finch. The same counts for this example. The search range and the result range do not align. So again, I get a wrong answer. Justin does not work in IT, but in sales. So different sized ranges do not cause an issue as long as the relative position of the matched value from the search range does not exceed the size of the result range. That's how you use Google Sheets lookup function. If you liked the video, please give it a thumbs up and do not forget to subscribe to our channel for more Google Sheets formulas and other spreadsheet-based automation ideas by Sheetgo. Thank you very much.